Summer of 2009, after being declared the winner of his Senate race, Al Franken embraced State Auditor Rebecca Otto. Now, Otto, who's also running for governor, writes, "It's in the best interest of Minnesotans and of women everywhere for Senator Franken to resign and set an example to powerful men." She didn't mention him by name today, but didn't need to.
"That we talk about it even when it is our friends, so that we have a safe place for our children, our nieces, nephews, and grandchildren."
Leanne Tweeden is the ABC radio personality on the receiving end of the unwanted onstage kiss and the now infamous photo on the airplane. Today, she appeared on The View, reading from a personal apology Franken sent her.
It says, it's on letterhead from Al. It says, "Dear Leanne, I want to apologize to you personally. I don't know what was in my head when I took that picture, but that doesn't matter. There's no excuse, and I understand why you could feel violated by that photo. I remember that rehearsal differently, but what's important is that the impact it had on you, and you felt violated by my actions, and for that I apologize."
And there's the tweet from the president. "Al Franken's picture is really bad, speaks a thousand words. Where did his hands go in pictures 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 while she was sleeping?" White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders was pressed on whether the president was being hypocritical, considering accusations against him.
"How is this different?"
I think in one case specifically, Senator Franken has admitted wrongdoing and the president hasn't. I think that's a very clear distinction.
Now, most of Franken's fellow Democrats have condemned the action but aren't yet calling for him to step down. Now, feminist writer Kate Harding today in a Washington Post op-ed said that Franken should serve out his remaining term but should announce fairly early on that he won't run for re-election and that way give other candidates a better shot. Back to you, Julie.
Thank you, John.